Well, they call me the Snake Man. You can call me up anytime.
Some people think what I do is glamorous. Yeah.
How are you, George? You remember the big brown snakes I got you to take away from the quarterdeck apartments at Lennox that time? The ones that were fucking twisting and mating like that? They were bloody big bastards, weren't they? You got one of them, you jammed the other one in beside the fucking garage door. my mate filmed it. Today I still look at the footage and piss myself laughing. Alright. See you, George.
Bye. Long time ago, a lady asked me, why do you do this? After I helped her out, I said, because I love you. What? What do you mean you love me? You're not my boyfriend. I said, well, it's a different kind of love. This kind of love doesn't want anything in return. We're going to a suburb called Suffolk Park, south of Byron Bay, in a unit complex. She's got a black snake in her laundry. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move the things from the bottom shelf because you're not sure if it went in there or behind there.
I can't see that.
So all we're going to do is move things and see what happens. I've moved everything from the bottom shelf and the snake is not in the bottom shelf now. So what I have to do now is pull the cabinet out, which makes life very interesting. Some people think what I do is glamorous.
Nope, not under there.
Yeah, it's not under there, mate. I hate searching for snakes. As good as I am at what I do, I'm only as good as my last call. Now, you saw the snake go through there, so then that means the snake must have gone this way. Yeah. All right? Stop! Stop! Freeze, please.
I'm frozen.
That's it. Very good. I need to concentrate. Now, this is serious, okay? We're no longer. Definitely red, very black.
Do you like them?
Eh?
Do you like snakes?
Yeah. They're more civilized than people anyway.
If it bit me?
If it bit you?
Mm-hmm.
If the snake bit you here, what would you do for first aid?
A tourniquet.
A tourniquet doesn't apply.
Just wrap my
pressure bandage.
Pressure bandage is what I would
do. Pick up?
Pressure bandage
over the entire arm.
Mm.
And then? Where would you rest your arm?
On the side.
Huh? No, here is better.
Mm.
And then?
Mm. Go to hospital.
No. You call the ambulance and they come to you.
Oh God, if you're in the bush, that's a bit difficult.
Well, they call me the Snake Man. You can call me up anytime. Yeah, they call me the Snake Man. You can call me up anytime. There ain't no river I can't cross, baby. Ain't no mountain I can't climb.
Bye.
Bye-bye, dear. I'm glad you didn't get hurt.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Oh,
there's a snake in your kitchen. What's at it to bite you? A snake in your kitchen, in your cutlery drawer. Red-bellied black Pseudotis porphyriacus. Highly toxic snake. Nowhere near as toxic as a eastern brown or common brown snake, but nevertheless it is seriously toxic snake. One of my nicest experiences I've had not that long ago was I had a call from Triple O. It was an 85-year-old old lady. What's the problem with this? And I've got a brown snake in my bedroom. What? How do you know it's a brown snake? I said, I know my brown snakes. Within moments I knew she knew what she was talking about. You know. I actually found a snake. So I put it away and I went back and sat down. And she said to me, you know, I'm 85 years old, but right now you've made me feel like I'm 70 again. Thank you. And I thought, yeehaw! That was really nice. I have a soft spot for the weak and the infirm in the community, especially the elderly. They are of an age where they've done their time, they've paid their dues. Mind you, I've been offered so many cups of tea, I spend more time than often not going to have a peep.
Well, I've been catching snakes for many a long year now, up in the hills and around the bay. Well, it's a dangerous road to travel, and oh, so hard to make it pay. But if you got them death out of blues, baby, well, I can make them go away.